Hey guys, what's up? It's Moz here, and welcome back to another video. So tonight, I was actually reviewing some channels that you guys sent me in like my Twitter and Instagram DMs, and I noticed a lot of similarities in like why some of you guys just aren't growing your channels, or why some of you guys just aren't getting the views that I think you should be getting. So I made a list of like all the common mistakes I've seen people make, and that's what this video is going to be about. If you guys end up enjoying the video, then please do hit that like button, because we actually broke the goal of 10 likes for last week's video, and I'd love for this one to hit 15 likes. I know it's a stretch, but I really hope we can do it. So sometimes I like to do channel reviews live on YouTube, but I also like talking with you guys personally in my free time as well. So when I'm just hanging out, watching TV or something, I'll open up Twitter or Instagram, just scroll through my DMs, like my unread ones, and just talk with you guys. So if you guys like want a channel review someday, follow me on one of those sites, just DM me saying hey, and I'll do my best to get back to you. And if you just want to talk about your channel, we can do that, or we can talk about whatever you want. But anyways, for this video, the things that I'm going to be covering in the video are going to be pretty basic, but I still think it's worth watching, even if you've seen my other videos, because you still might learn something that you just didn't know before. But anyways, let's just start with the first thing. So the first thing that I want to talk about is going to be your SEO, and this stands for Search Engine Optimization. And this is a really big part of YouTube, and most people don't even know it matters because, for the most part, you can't really tell when other people are doing it. So let me try explaining it really quick. YouTube is basically like a search engine, basically exactly like Google, which is funny because Google owns YouTube. Anyways, when you search for something on YouTube, YouTube will give you an answer back with all the videos that it thinks best match what you were searching for. So let me give you guys a quick example with a YouTuber that I like to watch personally. His name is FaZe Rug. So let me pull up one of his videos really quick. All right, sweet. So I just pulled up one of his videos. This one is called Giving People the iPhone 11 If They Shave Their Head. Pretty cool idea. FaZe Rug is always doing some cool stuff on his channel. So if you guys don't know who he is, definitely check him out when you guys are done watching this video. But anyways, let me talk about the SEO that he did in this video. So SEO is kind of like broken down into three things when it comes to YouTube. So you have your title, your description, and then your tags. So I'm going to talk about the title really quick. It just goes right here. That's the title. Super easy, right? And then this right here is the description. So FaZe Rug's description is really unique in the way that he does his, and I'm going to talk about that more in a second. But the thing I want to talk about first is actually going to be your tags. And your tags, normally you're not able to see them for whatever video you're watching on YouTube. You'll have to download like a browser extension. So one I like to use is called TubeBuddy. I will have a link to it in the description below for like a 30-day free trial or something. But right here, you can see the tags that he uses for this video that he uploaded. So the first few tags are just like his name in different variations, right? So whenever someone searches FaZe Rug, this video is probably going to show up. And if they search Rug FaZe, same thing, right? But then he gets a bit more specific near the end, right? So if someone searches up for giving people the iPhone 11, or if they search up giving people the iPhone 11 if, then there's a pretty good chance that this video will show up. So we can quickly try it out right now. I'll hover over this, right click, copy, go into an incognito window, go to YouTube, go here, paste it, hit search, and as you can see, I'm almost hot. There you go. Yeah, first video is FaZe Rug's video, giving people the iPhone 11 if they shaved their head. So now I'm going to kind of explain what tags are. So I'm going to close out of this. I just want to show you guys that tags really do matter in how your videos rank in the search. So right here, everything that FaZe Rug put into his tags, these are things that he wants people to be searching for when they're just on YouTube in general, and that's when he wants his video to show up. So for all these tags that he has right here, he wants this video, the one that we're on right now, he wants this video to show up in the search results for any time someone searches for any of these things right here. So that's kind of like how tags work. So the reason that I wanted to talk about tags in like this part of the video is because whenever I'm reviewing someone's channel, I always look at their tags for their videos, and a lot of people end up putting like really pointless tags, or they don't even put tags in general. So I definitely want to make sure that I touch up on this part and kind of like explain how it works. If you guys want to learn more about tags, I'm gonna have a bunch of videos linked in the description below for literally every single thing I talk about. It's just gonna like go more in detail on that thing I'm talking about, so definitely check those out. But anyways, let's move on to FaZe Rug's description. And descriptions for bigger YouTubers are actually really unique these days. So I've been watching FaZe Rug for honestly years now. Like, I've been a huge fan of him for a while, and YouTube was much different like when he was first starting to pop off. You were able to do like really brief descriptions like this one and get by and end up doing pretty well. So right now, FaZe Rug is kind of like riding the wave of his own success. But if a brand new YouTuber, literally this is their first video they ever make, if they make a video with the same title, the same tags, obviously change out like the FaZe Rug part of it, and then the same description but like different social media links, their video is going to do nowhere near as well as FaZe Rug's did. And the reason why is because this is really the only line that FaZe Rug uses right here to actually describe his video. So essentially what I'm trying to say right here is that using a short description like this one that Rug is using right now wouldn't really work the same way for a new YouTuber, but the reason why it works so well for him and many other big YouTubers that you look at is because those YouTubers already have like a pretty big and well-established fan base. Like, FaZe Rug has 14 million subscribers almost right now. So because of that, their viewers will automatically click the video whenever they see it in the sub box, or the suggested, or the recommended, and things like that. And then that initial traffic itself pushes the video even more to like new viewers that YouTube thinks might want to watch this video. So let me quickly show you guys like an example of a good description for a smaller YouTuber who's just trying to like finally like start building their fan base. Alright, cool. So I just opened up a video of mine that I uploaded near the end of summer. This video has about 30,000 views right now, and it's just a video on how to get more frames per second on Minecraft, right? So that's the title right there. Pretty straightforward, how to increase your FPS in Minecraft. Right here, these are my tags, just things I want people to be searching for when I want my video to actually show up on YouTube. And then right here, this is my description. So as you can see, right away comparing it with FaZe Rug's video, my description is much more in detail because I want YouTube to like fully understand what I'm doing in my video. So this is a really big thing I want people to focus more on YouTube is make sure that you're actually describing what you do in your video in the description of the video. Because if you're just putting your social media links right here, which you can, right? I have all my social media stuff right here, and then I have like random links right here as well. But that's totally okay, and I highly recommend you do that as well so you can like increase your following overall. But you can't really increase your following overall if people just aren't finding your video in general. And if they can't find your video in general, there's a pretty good chance that you're just not doing this part right. And so that's really it. Like, just make sure that you're describing your video much more. You can just go to edit video for whatever video you're on. And there you go. Like, this is right here. This is your description. So you can just go ahead and start editing it right here. Make sure that you're fully describing your video so that YouTube kind of like knows what your video is and who to recommend it to, and you should be good to go. And now the second mistake that I see a lot of YouTubers make, because honestly I just don't even think they know the tool exists, but it's actually adding end screens to their YouTube videos. An end screen is basically your video's outro, but you can link to other videos in it. So now the reason why these are so helpful is because you can get your viewer to actually like start, like I'll show you guys really quick right now. I'll go to my end screen for this video. So this is a great way to like recommend more videos that you think the viewer would enjoy, because right here you're actually able to leverage that viewer's retention, or like their attention to you, and kind of like expand it onto your other videos. So I recommend two videos right here, and also link to subscribe to me directly. So if they want to click any of these two videos, they can, and then they can get automatically redirected to one of those videos, and they can keep watching me from there, which will give me another view, and even a potential subscriber in the long run. So coming up with like end screen ideas is really pretty difficult because you want to look aesthetically pleasing, and there's tons of ways that you can go about doing it, but one of my favorite ways is actually using Placeit. I just wanted to briefly give Placeit a quick thank you for being the sponsor for today's video. So you can actually go to placeit.net and check out a bunch of tools they have available for you to use. They have things like intro makers, thumbnail creators, end screen card templates like the ones I'm talking about right now, logo templates, and so much more. I should have some footage on the screen right now of me showing you guys how you can actually use Placeit. It's pretty straightforward and very easy to use. You can customize things like the font, text, colors, and so much more until it matches exactly what you're going for. So if that interests you at all, then guys, definitely check out the link in the description below for a 15% discount for monthly subscribers. Now, the last thing that we're going to talk about is going to be the core basics of YouTube, which I think everyone really should have down by now, but for some reason, whenever I'm reviewing channels on like Twitter or Instagram, I see many people struggling with it, and this is really just your channel branding. And channel branding really just consists of three things. It consists of your thumbnails, your channel art, which is the thing at the top, and then your channel logo, or like the profile picture, or whatever you want to call it. And like I said before, for really everything I've talked about in this video so far, I've made more in-detailed videos already in the past, like right here, how to make free thumbnails. I literally made that video, so I'm gonna have a bunch of videos linked in the description below that are gonna help you guys out a ton. But yeah, I do hope you guys did enjoy this video. Let me know if you guys do want like another video like this one right here, where I kind of like break down like the ins and outs of YouTube, because I'd love to make like a part two if you guys want one. But yeah, drop a like if you guys enjoyed, and once again, please be sure to check out Placeit in the description below. But other than that, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.